right, good morning, guys. Now we are back out here at the pond that I've been working on when I had the catastrophe with the new undercarriage. I say catastrophe. Oh, if I remember, I'll try to post a picture of it, but I had a sprocket segment come loose. A sprocket segment come loose and basically popped off to the point where it got hung up on the chain. And I just thank God that I had the door open. I heard a clicking. I got out and looked, couldn't see anything obvious, and then backed up real easy, and then, man, just all of a sudden stopped. Well, what had happened was those bolts had come untightened and loosened up and fell out. I called the mechanic that put the undercarriage on. He rushed out here, and I appreciate him doing that. He rushed out here, looked at it. We surveyed the situation and made the call that I was going to get with the dealer that I bought the undercarriage from and discuss things with them. So I went to the dealer and spoke with them, explained to them the situation. You know, we've got a bolt issue or something, and their mechanic, I think he is their shop foreman, came in and had mentioned that they had some bolt issues lately, and that they have had to go out and out the field, send service truck out and make repairs. So there was a bolt issue. So anyway, I sat down with the parts manager and we discussed things, and he graciously agreed to provide me with new bolts and nuts. And I asked him about putting cap bolts back in it instead of the bolts that came with the undercarriage. How much difference? I was willing to pay the difference. If there was a difference in the cost, I would pay the difference to get cap bolts. So anyway, we made an agreement. Got all cap bolts now, and I'll show you here. We have all cap bolts. So the mechanic came back out and pulled all the sprocket segments back off, cleaned everything back up, put the cap bolts in, retorqued and tightened them. Because on this machine, you torque them to a spec, and I don't remember what the spec is. And then after you torque them, you take and you turn them an additional, I believe, 90 degrees. That sets the final torque on them, and that's the way they're designed to do. So anyway, he did come out, pulled them all back off, and I've got to say the dealership took care of me. The parts manager agreed to pay the labor to have him come back out and redo it. So hey, I can't say enough about Mac at Midwest Equipment. Hey, they took care of me, and they could have told me to go get bent, but they didn't. So they took care of me, and that weighs a lot with me, and I'll remember that, you know. So anyway, shout out to Mac at Midwest Equipment. Appreciate you guys, I really do. So anyway, back to the case at hand, no pun intended. And by the way, I should have had the mechanic weld up my bullet holes, but I didn't. I've got to get that done. I lack a little bit more to finish this part of the dam up. So you can see that probably where that grass is on top of the dam. I've got to steal some more dirt from over there, shuttle over here, so I can get this dam. I want to continue with my radius here. They've spread lime out here since I was here. Continue with the radius and just bring this kind of, just taper this in right here. But I'm gonna have to seal some more dirt. And then I want to get that spillway cut, final cut in. I gotta have to bring the laser, or I've got the laser, gotta set it up. Get some shots, get that spillway cut in, so I can be ready the first of the week to get the material laid down and get some rock in there. So anyway, that is a plan, and I have rattled on too much. I've had a few folks kind of chew my butt about talking too much, and I don't intend on doing that, but I also had a few in the past chew my butt for not explaining what the project was, so I'm trying to hit it in the middle. But anyway, guys, all right, we're gonna get started. All right, guys, well, it's gonna be pretty boring. mean, even if I had to replace the bolts myself, the bolts aren't that expensive. And even if I had to replace the bolts myself, I was going to do that. Sometimes this hardware is, you know, cheapest bid, you know what I mean?
Thank you.
Alrighty guys, well, we're done. Pretty well done with the problem. I do have to, because my OCD, I'm gonna make another pass or two just on the inside of that dam there a little bit, to kind of smooth that up. And I am gonna kind of make a pass over here on this, because I just cut it with a loader, but I am gonna take and blade that and make that a little bit nicer. But anyway, here's our spillway. It cut in pretty good. I had to get a little bit deeper than what I would have liked to have, but anyway, I'll take and lay material down in here. We're gonna put we'll put some riprap down in here, which would be like a 3x10 rock. Bad thing is I don't have the excavator here to place the rock, so I'm not looking forward to this. I'm gonna have to do it with a loader, and that could be a nightmare. I may end up by using the dozer, because I may have to end up by getting down in here, and I would so like to have the excavator here, but I hate to pull it in here strictly for laying this in there, because it won't take that long. This is where I wish I had a mini X, but what do you do? You can only have so much. Probably got more than what I need. But as you seen earlier when I was filming, my SD card's about full, so I've got so much. I have a bunch of different videos on there. But as you've seen how this is, how the dam came out, it came out pretty good. All in all, had to move quite a little bit of dirt yet. A little bit of final sweep up to do. But I mean, you can see it. Laid in here pretty good. I didn't throw any sprocket segments on the loader yet, so that's good. Whatever that was. Well, that may have been close. Anyway, as you can see, it didn't turn out too bad. Nice and uniform, pretty. So the owner was out here earlier, so wish I had a little roller, smooth drum roller, I could take and run on this. I mean, it's just aesthetics. The cows are going to get on it and are going to tear it up anyway. I don't know, I just like things smooth. But anyway, well, before the dark gets me, guys, I'm going to go ahead and get on out of here, I guess. You can kind of see how that's going to lay in. I'd like to have had just a little bit more fall. There's 8 inches or so. But as long as we got some fall, I don't want the water, I don't want it to smoke down through here, because it'll blow everything out down on that end. I want just a nice steady flow out of here. But it has to be fast enough that it doesn't back the water up and it crawled the dam. So anyway, well guys, before the dark gets me, I'm gonna get out of here. Don't forget to like and subscribe, leave comments, ring that notification bell, and that way you know I post a new video. Also, more pictures on Instagram, so don't forget to follow me there, and that's at dirtdaddy953. So anyway guys, I'm gonna get on out of here and we'll see you later.